1,065 days successful day failure to where I have reached it. It took me 3 years almost. Good afternoon, everybody. Audible? Okay, I see a few. I found a Bengali friend here. I'm so happy to see a Bengali guy here from Indonesia. So welcome, Anub, to Bombay. I'm going to talk on digital marketing and branding, but I thought through this session, let's make it interesting. So I thought I'm going to talk and help you understand how I build myself. Before I start, I have most of the presentations are mostly empty slides, one or two lines. So I'll tell you how I build my brand. I worked for almost 2 decades. Few of my colleagues are here. They're also getting an award in the evening with me. I started after working for 2 decades. What I did is that I used content marketing and inbound marketing and digital in a such a format that I don't have a single salesman in my team. Zero salesman. I don't go, I don't pitch, I don't look for business. I don't have even a proposal letter. Zero. So ever in our company, we will never have a BD. So you have client servicing people, you go and call, you follow up. I don't even follow up. I just don't do anything like a traditional guy do. So I could build my entire digital marketing company. You must be thinking, this guy is talking, but who are your clients? So let me give you a guess. My client is World Bank. Did I went to World Bank? No. They found me. How? I'm going to talk on that. Next, you must be thinking, so what? How much business you have got? 2 crore in just 1 year. Tell me one company who can do 2 crore in just 1 year without a single sales pitch, without a single sales business meeting. Every client, oh, one more thing, it's interesting. You will understand how powerful is digital marketing and how you can build brand. I reject 97% of my client. I reject 97% of my client, which means all the clients who come to work with us, I choose whom I want to work. I have not seen much company who follow strictly digital marketing to a level where you don't need any salesman. So I'm going to talk on this. I got some 40 slides. I'll make it very fast. You can tweet me. I'm going to put this video on my social channels after maybe 2-3 days once I get the video. I have a few of my people here around. One more interesting thing, there are some people who work with me are here. I found I'm his ex-boss. Sita was my ex-colleague, and I have some 1, 2, 3, 4 people who are taking my content. People who work with me, I don't have their CV because I never interviewed them. They also came to me. Think about it. They came to me. So in the first 6 months, I didn't pay them. Zero salary for the first 6 months. Why? Because I was teaching them on digital marketing, and the deal was, if you see that I'm cheating or I'm not talking or not teaching you for the first 2 days, you should penalize me and you should leave me. We have 20 people team working for Indian clients and international clients in this format. How I did it, I'm going to tell you. All of you can just replicate what I did. You can do more than what I did, right? So first thing, let's not talk about all these things. These are, you can Google me. By the way, if you can't type my entire spelling, even if you do the first 4 or 5 alphabets, Google will still find me. I have not paid a single money to Google. Zero SEO, zero AdWords, only content marketing I did. So Google stands, I stand number one in the Google without paying Google. So how to do that? Hacking, simple. If I can do, all of you can do that. I'm going to teach on these things. First, how to build a brand. It can be physical brand, it can be individual brand, it can be a corporate, it can be anything. Any goddamn thing in the earth. So, first rule, building takes time. Everything. Even God takes 9 months time to give a birth to a kid, right? A baby? 9 months. 10 days. It doesn't happen overnight. So I wrote a blog on this. It took me 1,065 days, unsuccessful days, failures, to where I have reached today. So it took me 3 years almost time. So any business or whatever brand you're trying to build, give them 1,000 days. There's a kahavat in someone told me, in people who are in Ahmedabad, they use this. 1000 days is a must for investing into a brand. Second, learn to sacrifice first. First, you have to give. You have to give the brand. Because a brand behaves like a kid. So if you start expecting, when do I get my lead? You'll die fast. First thing is to build and invest on the brand, digitally or non-digitally, whatever format you're going to do. But you have to sacrifice, you have to give and give and give so that you actually make the brand very, very strong. So how and what? We're going to talk on that. I've seen this, most of the brands and people who personally brand themselves, they put a lot of social media status. They're useless. No one cares about you. While coming to the stage, I just posted, I'm going to talk on this topic. I think 100 people have started commenting, when do I look for your video? We want to see the video. So I've not changed my DP on my WhatsApp or my Snapchat. Here I am. No one cares. So you have to give value. People look for content. They don't look for you. They don't like your face. So you only like hundreds and thousands of selfies happening. It's meaningless, right? This is the most important part, how I could build. By the way, I am not a businessman. The entire, I think, entire generation of my family, they have never done business. My father was a professor. We start from a very humble, below average, demographic where I come from, right? And I didn't have a capital, right? I started everything from one chair and one table in AWFIS, which is a business center. 5,000 rupees is what I did, right? So what I did is what I traded with my people, that you come with me for 6 months, I'm going to teach. I traded knowledge and nothing else. That was my only capital. I think all of you have that. If you don't have, this is the most interesting part. If you are not having the domain knowledge of your subject, of your topic, of your brand, you will not survive. You can get 500 awards, it will not take you far. Social media should be treated as your asset. Every social media, if you go to, I've seen LinkedIn, I've seen a lot of posts, Jai Mata Di, on LinkedIn, right? They put a lot of quotes, meaningless quotes, it has no meaning on LinkedIn. Social media like Facebook, you should use, how I use Facebook, I use Facebook like LinkedIn. So there are certain rules I'm going to share. If you do that, you stand up, people start noticing you and they will come to you and they will ask for business. If you ever, after my session is over, if you see my card, my business card have nothing. No phone number, no email ID, no Twitter handle, nothing. Nothing. It just have Digital Fellow logo. Because if you search Digital Fellow, you'll only find me. If I'm discovered in 0.4 second by the Google, do I need a number? So each of my social media are absolutely carefully curated. If you do that, you get found. If you do that, you get discovered. If you do that, people start respecting you. And people will come to you to pay you. By the way, most people here, in every business, I see all my friends, everybody is one channel. How to get business? I don't have channels from day one. Zero challenge. I have enough business. I only pick and choose people whom I want to work. Just imagine. This is the rule. 1-9-90. 1% of your community, whoever is sitting here, whatever community you are, whatever business you are doing, only 1% of your community actually create content. 1%. 9% share, comment and likes. And 90% do nothing. They just don't know how to build content. So if you want to survive in your business, if you want to build your brand, all you need to do is create content. Create original content. Don't hire a stupid copywriter who will copy 20 things from different website and you imagine and you psychologically and you feel that, wow, I have done some content. Google understands in 0.2 seconds that all those content has been copied from 20 other things. You have to create original content. No one cares what content you're giving, provided Google cares. Google needs to know what you're doing. So this rule, 1-9-90, if you want to survive and do great business, you need to be a part of that 1%, not 90%. This is the most important part. Everybody look for business. Never look for business. Never ask for business. I skipped my slide. None of you know what I do. All you know, I'm in some digital. I've not told you my service. You have to be a giver. So here at the platform, I've seen people come in conference and pitching. This is what I do. So technically, please come and buy. This is my service. This is my card. Can we meet? You don't need to do that. First, you have to be a giver. First, you have to give. The moment you are a giver, people will look at you. They will find you and they will actually pay your price. Most of the people I see here around me, they have a problem of conversion. I have no conversion problem. You have meetings, right? Lot of, you know, rounds of meeting where you negotiate. People don't negotiate with me. They come with a paycheck. I charge my price and I never do a negotiation. Take it or leave it. How can I do that? Because from day one, if you see any of my content, not a single place you will find what is my service. I've never sold my service. Never. Any content you picked up, more than 2,000, 3,000, maybe 10,000 content I have, not a single time I've sold myself. I've given them even a hint what I do. Definition of value. Most people don't understand this in this country. They think giving some scheme and giving some features and giving some offer is a value. No, no one cares about you. Value is what you are looking at. Are you solving a pain? If you're actually helping someone, any of you follow Gary Vee? Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. If you see Gary Vee or any top influencers who are great speakers, they don't sell their service. Gary Vee makes more money just talking than his Vaynerchuk Media. So if you're giving value is something when you actually are a giver, when you're actually giving meaningful content, when you're changing people's life, that's what a value is all about. Value is not scheme and five features. No one is interested. Then if you're doing that, then you're competing with one with another. So there are 1,000 people in this room, all are trying to give some feature and some value. I really don't care about it. I've seen people fail because you are one of the 10th or 11th or 100 vendor outside waiting to get sold. I get bought. I get found. I never sell because I give value. So all my content, whatever way I can, I try to teach, help, educate. Next, this is what people do. They send you a link in WhatsApp. Can you share? Why are you begging? Can you just like my thing? Who cares? So this thing, if you're looking for, if you're begging to get shared, that's a traditional approach. No one cares about you. No one will like. And that like means nothing. Next, people look for, I see still a lot of clients look for likes. How many likes you have? Like versus A versus B. Like actually means nothing. If they are commenting, if they are sharing your content, that's value. That's what is meaningful. So you can buy likes. I can tell you 10 software which are from the mobile firm. You can buy, you can pay 2,000, 3,000 rupees and you can buy a few lakhs of likes on Instagram, whatever. How does it hit your balance sheet? I don't think so. So like means nothing. Shares mean everything. Comments mean everything, right? So go and Google any of my, if you go to LinkedIn also, if you see any of the content which I post, have 10, 15, 20, hundreds of communication. People are interacting with me. That's important. That's when you connect. That is valuable. Every blog I post, I get business. Every blog. I take around 2 weeks time to create a content, generally a blog or a video or everything I do. I every time I post something, I get one client. Every time. So I just shared, it has no value. So shares and comment is important. Yeah, most of the people who want to build persona or you want to build their profile, a LinkedIn profile or a social media or a WhatsApp, selfie don't take you far. It has no meaning. Okay. Next, there's a rule of 70-30. So if you, 70% of your content should be a principal content. Even if you are, you know, a marketing guy or you're a person for doing whatever you're doing, your total subject is maybe pharma, maybe auto, maybe whatever, email marketing or marketing automation, whatever you're doing. 70% should be that and 30% should be a personal. So someone who can do a five times scroll of your profile should know who you are and what you do. That's it. That's how you build brand. So don't unnecessarily put selfie, it doesn't mean anything. So if they understand from five scrolling who you are, what you do, they will actually seek your advice. So I mentor, apart from my work, I speak in business schools, around 50 schools I've covered. Last 3 years I've been talking in only IIM Indore. I have only picked up the four or five best schools. I speak in IIM for 3 years. Did I apply? No. IIM found me. The IIM professor was looking at my content. After 1 year, he said, Shubha, will you be interested to talk in my forum? Will you be interested to come and share your knowledge? So I get always found. Always. All the time. So I don't have a number or anything else in my visiting card. By the way, I don't even give visiting card. Okay, so if I can do that, all of you can do that. Because I was building my content for last 10 years. Build your profile with care. I think a lot of people who look for jobs on LinkedIn, their LinkedIn profile is horrible. Sometimes spelling mistake. And their picture is with a dog or some Lonawala they must have taken up. So it's horrible. So if you see the background of a LinkedIn, there's a profile. It's been done for a purpose. If you come to my LinkedIn, you will see, without even scrolling my content, you will know this guy is a speaker. How can I can do that? Because content have two parts, visual part and the text part. The visual part is a brain which decodes information a little faster. How faster? 11 million contents come to us, data. Brain can only decode 40%. And within that 40%, it is the visual we read faster. 60,000 times faster, all of us know here. People who have gone through several digital conferences know this math. Brain and eyes reads any visual 60,000 times faster than the text. So no one cares what your headline is. They see the image first. So if an image is a cut paste of a Google, most company I've seen, they don't invest on an image. You know, you just get a free image from Google. Everybody is taking free image from Google and an entire campaign get lost. You have to invest on image. So if your profile or image is not, you're not caring, people will not care about you. Next, LinkedIn is not Facebook. Each people come for a different tone. I've seen lots of stupid content on LinkedIn. And people laugh. People laugh at you. And they will never hire you. Or they will never think that you are a serious guy because you're posting stupid content. And you don't know the difference between Facebook and LinkedIn. I see a lot of things. It's like, you know, in fact, I see this happening day in, day out. And even the CEOs do that, not the younger people. Jai Mata Di and Hare Krishna and all the stuff. LinkedIn is not for that. LinkedIn is only for sharing content, sharing what you know, sharing your professional thing. You want to share, you want to teach, you want to educate. You're sharing a success on digital or professional forum. That's what LinkedIn is. So, many people cut, copy, paste other people's profile and paste. But if you see the entire content, you'll figure out that this content has been copy-paste from someone else. Write your own content. Is it a very task to do that? Same content everywhere people post. I see people, when they post a picture, they post the same thing goes on an Insta photo, same thing goes on a Facebook. Immediately, if he's connected to your Insta, you will find everything same photo. It's boring. No one cares. Because every time, you're abusing the channel. You're actually abusing his timeline. You're bothering him. A time will come, he will start unfollowing you. He will block you. They will not be able to find you or another 1,000 people who are stupid. So your content is you. Girls here, I give this example to people. I mean, men don't take so much time to dress, but girls take, imagine you're putting an eyeliner or you're putting a kajal, right? You try to match left eye and right eye and the thickness, right? And you take time. Till the time it is perfect, you don't move away from the mirror, right? Why you do that? Because you're caring. People will look, you look horrible. Why don't you do the same thing with your content? You just vomit whatever is coming. How people will think about it? If you do that, you think you're going to build content? I don't think so. So same content is not to be spread on different channels. Next, this is the biggest problem of the client. They look for immediate gratification. You know, I've posted, I must get 20 likes. I must get some few comments. It takes time. I was watching a video of Alibaba or Coke. Coke was sold only 3 bottles in the first year. Alibaba, Jack Ma says the first 3 years they were losing. So people take time. Apple also was not sold or successful in the first 2 years, 3 years time. So immediate gratification kills people, client, and there's a mindset. So don't look for immediate gratification. It will take time. The algorithm takes time to take off. So even if you go through my old content, not even people commented anything on my thing. Did I stop? No. Never. This is why I said, visuals and design is everything, because brain reads this faster than the text. This is a very, very sad truth and a hardcore universal thing. Content building is a very lonely affair. I sit back in my office with my content team, spend hours and hours trying to create an original content. And it's so much sad, and sometimes you don't know people will read it or not. Sometimes most of the content which I spend 1 month time to create, no one even bothers to read. But you should keep on doing it. It's a very lonely affair. It takes time, but it works like magic. It just worked like the magic. So that is the reason I could build a company out of nothing, with no sales team, with no pitch, and no number on my visiting card. I don't go out and, have you ever seen me? I was here for the last 2 hours. I've not even given a single card to anyone else. I really don't care, because there are thousands of people are finding me. How can I do that? Because my content sells me. So I sprinkle my content across the social channel, blogs, and you know, webinars and videos, and people find me, they come to me. So content takes time, always. You don't look for immediate gratification. One video will never give you business. It took me some time, more than 3 years to be here. But I was building my social media content for the last 10 years. 10 years, not 1 or 2 years. Curating my content. So content building always takes time. Next, people who are not, if you're working, if you don't know how to manage, don't look for everything. Look for one channel and hit it. And keep on hitting it time and time till the time you really become master of the channel. So I started with Facebook. I leveraged Facebook. I started getting business for Facebook. Then I moved my focus from Facebook to LinkedIn. LinkedIn is almost, I'm getting saturated. Everything I do, how much of you know, people views your content on LinkedIn? Raise hand and tell me a number. 200? 2,000? 5,000? 15,000? I don't see anyone in this room can cross a 15,000. Any content, any meaningful content I post, please go and check. It starts with 5,000. It hits 25, 34, around 36,000 people. So why do I need a salesman? 36,000, go and check. Right now you can Google my name and just type the first 4 or 5 alphabets. You will find me. So each channel is important. Give time. We have a lot of patience. You will get result. Muscle takes time. It doesn't get you on the first day of the gym. It's a process. It takes really a lot of time. Next, this is what generally kills you, cut pest. The attitude is really cut pest. You think your colleague don't know, but Google knows. The spider crawler knows that you have copied. There's not original content. So cut pest will never take you. Never, ever. You should know the rules of each channel, and then, because you can't hack the algorithm. It is done with lot of mechanism in the background. If you don't know the rule, you don't know if you are using the way you are putting your Instagram stories on LinkedIn, the algorithm will not hit. So there is time and days of time when you should publish your content. And you should actually measure it. I have a guy sitting here, I can't see him. He's the backside. This guy, his job is to actually do a math, which day, at what time, content is getting more viewed, content, comments, share and likability. So I learn every day. So there's no rule, you and I. So we learn from the analytics and then figure out which algorithm works at what time. Next, never do this. Never ever do this. Never boost your content. Because I think in this country, India, I don't know about other country, because I've worked in 9 more countries. Indonesia also much more, I don't see the same mindset. Facebook actually spoiled us. Most people who don't know anything on digital, seeing the Facebook post, they think this is so easy, no? Just pay 1,000 rupees and it will go to 1 lakh people. Imagine your serious book product or anything else, a serious pharma product or anything else, or something which is a noble charity or whatever, it is coming when you spray content with this Facebook boost. Imagine it comes between 2 Tinder images. People will buy you. They're not in the mood. They're swiping girls. So never boost. It's all about targeting. There you should do a proper targeting to do that. Yeah, this I spoke, Jai Mata Di on LinkedIn, and I see still now, right? Push quality, not the quantity. Initial start with small, meaningful content. And the content may not be blog, it can be a micro content. It can be a 150 word, 200 word, things what you see. Start making content and gradually look for, you will see a lot of people commenting. This is something a little advanced, because most people still don't know how to do this. All channels should integrate between each other, and then you get huge amount of response. So my Medium blog, I hope people know Medium here, medium.com. Okay. So if you use Medium and then you ask people to read your blog, from that blog he goes to Instagram, and from Instagram bio he goes to your Twitter handle. On Instagram there's a software called Linker, L-I-N-K-R, please note down. If you use Linker, you can use multiple channel on the bio. So if someone goes to your Instagram and there's one text you're supposed to, you know, a link you're supposed to give, if you put Linker, you can make him go and choose to your blog, to your website, to your app. That's how you integrate. Simple. It doesn't need any marketing automation. Very simple, right? Should do that. Next, never do this. Companies, people, they hire cheaper people. When I say cheap, unskilled people. 15,000 rupees a copywriter. You think he will going to give you volume? You don't even know even you know how to test a headline. So the process of testing a headline. Please write down if you know headline analyzer. There's a software, free software. Headline analyzer will tell you if the headline is good enough for people to remember. Headline analyzer, very simple, right? It will tell you the important words, the alphabets, the power words. If you put a question, if you put a number, how brain will read that headline. If the headline is not read, the entire content is gone. So all these things, you know, can be done easily. You don't need a digital team for that, right? Yes, this is what I keep saying. Don't try to be a dog and try to learn to bark. So if you have dog at home, you are not supposed to bark. Hire people who are good at what? Don't try to do everything else, right? You are not good at anything. So we are human beings, we are not supposed to bark. Hire a dog, the dog will bark. So similarly, you should hire people who are expert into whatever zone they are. Don't try to do, learn many things, you will not able to, because every 6 to 7 months time, digital algorithm process, everything is changing. So have you seen a digital book in a bookstore? Other than dummies, please buy one dummy for digital from any store. Half of the book is irrelevant now, because they can't print every 2 months or 6 months time. It is so diverse and it's changing, ever changing. It's very difficult to cope up. So you can actually learn digital through online videos, blogs, and that is the reason you don't have to, it's very difficult to cope up with so much of speed. The first session was all about marketing automation. I don't know how many people in this room could understand what that guy said. It's a very deep dive data mining, machine learning. So you don't need to do that and learn that. You hire an agency, a people who understand that and give the task and analyze. And so as a manager issue, your job is to figure out whether it is working for you or not. Next, So I don't know any of you have, all of you have a college degree, right? All of you are graduates. So the degree lasts how long? Till the time you are alive, right? Right? Till that time you and I am alive, our degrees last. Try to do a Google test. Get a Google certificate. It only lasts for 6 months. Why? If you take a Google Stack test, if you take a HubSpot test, if you take analytic test, it only survive for 6 months. That's it. After that, you have to take, you know, everything has changed. So your old degree are obsolete now. So that is the reason all these 2 decades of work or 2 decades of knowledge or whatever I have done, all my MBAs and all, I have put it in a dustbin. It has no use now. I think I have only 4 or 5 years experience and I'm learning. If you go to any of my profile, I don't write a marketing guru, I said an avid reader, because still I don't know anything of marketing. I'm still learning. So old degree, if you have, you know, people love to, you know, love the degrees. I'm from IIM, I'm from Mica, I'm from X, I'm from Y. And that is going to be my, you know, passport to survive. God help you, nothing will not work. All your P4Ps and 4Cs will not work on digital, right? Everything is changing every 6 months. Next, I see most CEOs and the top people, they look for that blue tick, Twitter and LinkedIn, blue tick. Nothing is to do with that. You know, first get into content, Bluetooth will happen when it is going to happen. So don't look for all these, aesthetics, which has no value in the immediate impact business. I know Sita knows this. I don't know, any of you know these words? Tofu, bofu, mofu? Raise your hands. One, I guess that. Sita, don't raise your hands, I know that. So, you also don't, Prasad. Fine, four. So, two or three people out of this, what, 50 people sitting here, don't even know. Tofu is not that Chinese food, I mean, Japanese food, by the way. It's top of the funnel, middle of the funnel, and the bottom of the funnel. Each funnel have a different mindset. We go through a content through that mindset, and that is the reason I make loads of business and money just using content marketing and this. And that is the reason I don't have zero sales team. And that is the reason I don't even go for pitch. People call me if you are pitching. In fact, last evening I was with Sabuni, my colleague, and Times of India called us. They said, will you do this job? We said, no, this is an agency job. We are not interested. I reject all the time. How can I do that? Because I do this. And does it needs a great, by the way, I'm not a great, what you say, marketeer. All I did is what I learned and execute on the second day, and it's giving me result. All of you can do that. Next, this is the most important part. People spray and they pray. Your bosses will say, spray, you know, put content, press it, go to YouTube, Facebook and spray. Someone will read and someone will buy. This is called spray and pray theory. It doesn't work. It works on digital, non-digital. It doesn't work on digital. You're not supposed to do spray and pay content. You should be very, very curate. You should actually understand and push it out only to people who are meaningful, who understand your content meaning, you know, understands your content and value it. Please learn new tricks or you'll die fast. In fact, I wrote three consecutive books. It's coming up. How to suicide digitally. I thought I keep talking and people don't understand. Let me talk a very harsh word, at least they will understand. If you want to die digitally and suicide digitally, please tweet me, I'll send you that book. Follow all those rules, you will anyway die. So your job is not to do that. So there's a book on, and very simple manner I've told in that book. So Twitter is Subhobroto C, is my Twitter handle. If you tweet, I'll send you my link. Please read that. How to die digitally, so you should learn all the time. All the time. And watch videos all the time. Follow the influencers every day, all the time. I use the way you use WhatsApp, I use LinkedIn all the time. Neil Patel, Gary Vee, read the content and use it in your work every day. You will never forget. Times travel very fast in the digital end. So if you think you have a degree, by the way, course was constructed by me, or any courses you have done, someone was telling me how to do a course on. So I keep smiling. I said, why do you want to waste your time? 1.5 lakhs, the course is going to only last you for 6 months. That's it. So you don't need to do any course. Keep on learning all the time and use it in your daily work. Because it's like if you are 2 months not reading, you are 2 years behind. Minimum 2 years. When I go to Calcutta, my own city, where I don't live right now, I live in Bombay right now. I feel that they are like in 20th century, 19th, 16th, 17th century. They're so backward. They don't understand. They are still looking for likes. Okay, cool. Next. So all of your phones upgrade, right? You have those notifications coming in. Upgrade. When was the last time you upgrade yourself? Ask it. Ask yourself. The last time people who have upgraded either have gone to their college, which is 10 years, 5 years. I see average age of 30 year or 27 or 30 years age. The last upgradation done was your college degree or maybe one or small 2 degree you have done so far. It will not take you far. You get killed in digital very fast, just like that, because you will not be able to manage. So if you are not upgrading and reading all the time, God help you. Even if you hire an agency, you will not know how to control the agency. If you hire a content writer, you will not know whether she or he is writing the good content. If you hire a great performance agency, you will not know what are the metrics is right or wrong. By the way, education is free. HubSpot didn't pay me. You can do HubSpot. There are 7 exams of Google. If you do that, you get into understanding digital very fast. So you don't need to do a course to put it on a LinkedIn and look for a job. You will get a job. But you will mess it when people, you will not be able to solve problems of the business. So first learn and keep learning. It will make you survive and you can build your brand easily. Last 10 years, I have been in Bombay. I have never looked for an interview. I always get found. Not a single interview I have gone through any consultant. Only my content shows me I'm a very keen marketeer. People called me. So National Stock Exchange, I was a vice president there. The CEO hired me after 2 years because he found me value. So that's how I could build my own content and my company, just doing meaningful, valuable content. All of you can do that. I'm not a great engineer or doing rocket science. I just curate my content in a manner people find me. Yeah, I spoke on this. Your certificate will not take you far. Please don't look for a certificate. Right? It means nothing. If you can't execute, you will not be able to survive. Right? You can't take your HubSpot or Google certificate. Oh, I know, you know, SEO. You can't solve my problem. Right? Next, respond in real time. Any of you try connecting me through any of my channel. Any of my channel. Any odd hours. Till 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock, I didn't respond. I respond in less than 2 minutes. Try it. Try it. Any point of time. I talk in real time. I help. I mentor so many students. More than 20 to 30,000 students are just now, well, before coming into stage, 3 people approached me. This is a problem. Can you solve it? I said, I'm going on the stage. Give me 1 hour time. I'll be back. So I always respond in real time. The moment you start responding in real time, you actually prove one thing. I care for you. And they will come back to you. And on, you know what I did? If 1 o'clock or 2 or 12 o'clock, if someone is looking for a marketing problem and I'm solving, you know what I did? I actually made him my sales fund the rest of his life. He will always remember me, and whenever he goes up in a ladder, he will always call me, Shubho, we have a problem. Can you solve? That's how I make salesman every single day, by responding. We should respond with a lot of care. This is the most important thing, the last stage of my presentation. Never try to sell. No one bothers. Please educate and help. If they find, they will buy from you. If you try to sell, they will make sure you are among the 500 vendors outside looking for a, you know, with a price. If you're looking at someone's pocket, they will not like it. Behave like a friend, look at the heart. Help him, give him a solution, and don't try to be a selfish trader. Transactional relationship will die. Look for a meaningful, friendly relationship, they will come to you. If you try to sell and look for the pocket, people will hate you. If you're looking to solve his problem, they will fall in love with you. And people who come to me, they don't negotiate and they don't ask. I am very, very premium. Very premium. They don't even, some, there's a client who didn't, he didn't negotiate. He said, okay, we would like to work with you. How can I do this magic? Because I never sold anything. This is one of the biggest problems. Most of the CEOs and the top people, all the, I see, you know, I should not talk more about my past companies because my, I see my colleagues are here, ex-colleagues are here. This is the biggest problem in this country. I don't know. Everybody is knowledgeable, right? So event managers have started their digital outfit because looking for digital. Right? Everybody is making digital, and half knowledge is so half and so dangerous. Sometimes I feel like jumping off my office and die. So please don't have a half knowledge. If you know, if you don't know, admit. There's no sin in it. I also don't know many things, right? So I keep on learning, right? So you'll keep learning and upgrading yourself. So don't attack or try to solve with your traditional degree and solve a digital problem. It will not work. This is the most important part. Digital is a mindset. It's a mindset. It's not a technology, not a content, nothing. It's how you approach it. If your mindset is traditional, you will not be able to manage digital. Most CEOs or SMEs or people who are traditional, they try to adopt digital and try to put it on a traditional box. It doesn't work. It just doesn't work, right? So if you are not knowledgeable, you will not be able to interact with and tell your boss. Yeah, this is, I spoke on the first. Don't try to abuse a channel. No one is interested in your selfie, by the way. No one. Put meaningful content, people will start queue up to buy your services. I just wrote this at 5 o'clock in the morning. I never repeat my presentation. Never, ever. So any of you have, anyone have seen my presentation, will always see a fresh content. Why? I don't cut, copy, paste. What I said, I do. So 5 o'clock I got up and made this presentation. And I was going through one of the Facebook posts. There's one boy who got just married. Every day, every minute he will post. Today is Valentine's Day first. He is 30-year-old guy. spreading and abusing my timeline, giving me every minute detail of what his and his wife is doing every moment. Do I care? It's so funny and stupid. So every meaning update is not is meaningful, because people look at you and they think you're foolish. So don't do that with your social media or social channel or with your brand. Social media is free, and that doesn't mean you have to post everything. This is something your boss says most of the time. I've seen, you know, the biggest problem are the bosses, not the juniors. They want to learn and they want to come to a conference. When they go back, I want to execute boss. No. Just do. This is what I think is right. Right? That's the biggest problem. So the bosses should be coming more in the conference than the junior people. The biggest, I should not use an abuse word because I'm a platform. We'll talk on this later on. So yeah. So never ever put stupid content. And less is always more. I think this is important for a content, because less, when I say less, meaningful, amazing, thought-provoking. Just think of one thing. If you're putting a content, will it be covered by an editor of a newspaper? Yes, no. If it is no, it's not a good content. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Subhobroto. You know, on behalf of the organizing committee, we have a memento, small memento to give you. Can I have Mr. Arnab Ganguly on the stage, please?
A bong giving another thing to another bong. Good. I love it. Thank you so much. This is Ganesha, so it says, let's make more money. For me and none of you, right? Any question? Yeah, please.
Hello.
Yeah.
My name is Sumit, and I'm from Indira School of Business Studies.
Okay.
So my question is that for startups, there is no big budget to promote themselves, to invest money in the HubSpot-like platforms. So is there any better alternatives to go for?
So what do you sell?
For integrated marketing platform like the HubSpot.
No, that I understood. What services you sell?
Yeah, the better alternative for that.
No, I'll come to that. I'm asking you what product you sell. Do you sell any product?
IT services, digital marketing.
IT services, yeah. Okay. How long have you been working?
It's 10 to 15.
Okay. Do you have people who can, technology people who understand, write good content?
No, there are specific content writers out there.
So if you are writing only content, yeah, meaningful content, which are SEO friendly, post it on, never sell, never try to sell any of your service. Say, whatever I said, don't never do that. If you are helping a challenge and talk about through a blog, can you make blog?
Yes.
Does it need marketing automation software? Do that for 6 months. Write meaningful content from all of the funnel, top of the funnel, awareness stage, consideration stage, and decision stage. Go to HubSpot. If you Google HubSpot content marketing funnel, you get a grid. It will tell you at what level, what is it that you will talk. You can talk about your feature at the lower end of the bottom when he's in the decision stage. Yeah. That doesn't need any marketing automation software. You have a LinkedIn. Please pay 2,000 rupees and get a premium. By the way, LinkedIn has not given me anything to talk. This has actually worked for me. It will work for B2B, right? So what is the ticket size of any IT product which you sell? More than 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs?
No, it's up to 1, 2 lakhs. 1, 2 lakhs.
2 lakhs. Yeah. So do that for 2 to 3 months. Yeah. Use meaningful content. Make your website based on the funnel. Golden circle call, what is the problem I'm solving? How I'm solving? And why will people believe me? 3 step. Straight funnel, do it for 3 to 6 months, you will get result. You don't need any marketing automation software.
Okay.
I don't use. Nothing. No software. Yeah. Got your answer?
Yes, sir.
So free. Yep.
Hi, that was a wonderful presentation.
Thank you.
And it's not really a question, it's a concern that as a startup, the level of the pyramid where you are playing, the clients want immediate results. I totally agree to your point that brand takes time to be built, but for a startup, the kind of clients that we get, they want immediate results.
Yeah.
So
what is the service?
Digital marketing.
Oh, fine. So you are a digital marketing agency?
Yeah.
Right? You have all the services like?
SEO.
Yeah.
You
have a website?
Yes.
How many blogs do you have? You got my answer. If you are a digital marketing agency, and if your digital health and blogs, do you give value or do you sell? I can bet my life if I see 15 contents which you have posted on behalf of your company. With all due respect, I will see, you can also check, is all you're trying to sell. You try to post and say, this is what we do, please buy. This is what we do, please buy. No one cares. So people will start asking for a wrong gratification. They will say, I want lead from tomorrow. Okay? The first thing which I do, what you're trying to do is that you can do the same thing. The first onboarding of client, whoever comes to me, I charge them 3 lakhs and teach the 5-6 stakeholders who is going to work with me. I teach them the same thing which I just taught to all of you. I generally tell them, immediate gratification will not happen. I'm not a performance agency or SEO tool which will give you leads. Everything takes time. So once you establish through your content, you will start getting found by value-oriented leads and customers. So what is happening is a chicken or the egg story. You need to make difference in your content. So imagine you're a marketing guy, right? So managing it. So do you have your own podcast? Do you have your own videos? Do you have your own content? Do you have your own blogs where you are talking about best practices, the 20 things a CEO should know? Do you know, are you teaching people that these are the 5 things you should not do it? So the moment you do that, you will get found by the important client who actually value and they will never ask for a gratification. Since digital is little gray, not right, you know, everything and everybody knows everything, right? It's the biggest problem. The CEO will say, my daughter said, you know, I can get a like, my son-in-law is a good expert, he has done some courses, he will start, you know, flooding him with a lot of GAN, all idiots people. But how do you segregate an idiot with a person who is knowledgeable or someone who doesn't interpret digital as an immediate gratification? People look digital as a cheaper alternative. I saw that. And a hoarding cost 2 lakh, so they know that Facebook post is 1200, so digital is cheaper, right? So you post 1200 rupees and you get a lot of things, so what is it that you're going? So they will not value your content writer, they will not value your image. Why do you need to buy? Just, you know, copy it. My brother and sister and my cousin will give you free images. Why to buy? So the first thing you need to do, mindset change. Okay. If you do from the initial level, the mindset change, you will get attracted to good people who will value this. But if you're looking for mass marketing, which I don't do, mass marketing, you will never able to maintain this. So you have to choose. If you're an agency who is looking for performance only, then you use tools. So this guy in the morning, Hansa, is talking about data, you know, getting churning, getting lead nurturing, is all about, you know, data. You want to do that or you want to service? Whom do you want to service? Have you, okay, one thing I missed out last since I was up in the morning. Any of here, except these 3-4 guys, do you know persona?
Yeah.
Not brand persona, digital persona. None of you will know. Please Google and search. You know that? The last guy with specs? Hi. You know persona? You, yeah. So digital persona. So do you know how keywords come from persona? Do you know how you interview 3 people or 4 people or 20 people in a group and then get those personas and then you line up? So you should be doing persona for your business, which will give you, these are 5 categories of client. These 3 category or 2 category will not work. So before I started my company, if you ever come to an office, I'll show you in my sketch format, I did the person of people whom I don't want to work. If you're clear, you will never get stupid people in your life. Yeah?
Thank you so much. Just out of curiosity, how much time did it take you to get your first client?
People or the client?
The client, the first business.
First meeting or recently?
No, the first one when you started off.
I should not name, but anyway.
How much time it took you to...
First I posted my, I took me here, this boy, he helped me to build my first website and I did my content well. Am I taking a long time? One more minute, I'll close it. It took me 15-20 days time and one of the largest media house came to buy me when I had 1 chair and 1 table. I didn't sold myself. So that's the power, right? Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.